Tune into this week's Xamarin Show, where my good friend Dean comes on to talk about async void. Yes, async void and why not to use it and how to fix your code. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. We're back again with my good friend Dean to talk about best practices for async await. Now, Dean, you've done, you know, introductory, advanced, but I think we missed something important.
Yep.
The dreaded
async void.
That is correct.
Yeah.
Yes.
This one's a huge gotcha.
So what is async void and why is it an issue?
Yeah. So with async tasks, usually you want to return a task. And then on the task, you can await it. And the reason that the async keyword is there isn't because you're returning a task, but actually within that method, there's an await. So you can't call await if you don't have an async. So sometimes when a method doesn't return anything, you'd make it into a void method, right?
Yeah, like, oh, I don't need anything back, so why bother?
Why bother returning something? Yeah. That's just extra stuff. So what happens when there's an await inside of it, then you have to put async on it. Yeah. And then what happens is whenever an exception is thrown, the exception can disappear.
Oh, gotcha. So it's very, very tricky. And I've always heard, and you always see it on Twitter everywhere, like async void, evil.
Exactly.
So, all right, well, let's see what you got. Let's take a look at the code.
All right, so let's take a look. So this is a command. When we click a button, it'll just run this. And here we have an async void method within a try catch block.
So I see it right below there, right on line 55. Mm-hmm. Now this looks, you know, looks okay, right? I'm going to be calling, I assume, an await method inside of that async void method. Right there, I see it. Boom.
Yep, right
here. Line 64. Mm-hmm. And in the, this looks good. So async, it was void only because I needed to await.
Exactly.
So really, like you said, async await doesn't necessarily mean you have to have a task, because the async is pairing with
the await.
The await.
And internally.
So you're thinking here, well, you know, you know, it's probably squiggly.
Yeah.
You want to get rid of the squiggles, and that's how you do it, right?
Exactly. Yep. Just add this async, and then you can run it, right?
Yeah. Okay.
So the problem with async void is you can't actually await the method, even though it's async. So here we see our void method, but I can't await on it because it's void.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So it's just going to kind of go.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yep. So you can only await on tasks. So yeah, it's going to complain. So let's take a look at what happens when you execute this.
Yeah. And that, what does that do, that async void method, so we know what to expect, right?
Yeah. So this just runs a task that runs for 2 seconds and then returns a string.
Okay, gotcha.
A task string. But in this case, we're ignoring that return. So we're not returning anything, and the signature is just void.
Okay, got it.
All right. So let's take a look if we just run that. So we'll see that the command ended, and then the application blew up.
Oh, no.
What's the deal, right? I had a try catch.
Yeah, it looks good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's the deal?
What the heck, Dean? What's going on, man?
Come on, Visual Studio.
Yeah.
What's going on? So what happens is, if we take a look, and we look carefully, we'll see command ending actually happened before the async void method completed.
Oh, okay, got it.
So because we couldn't await it because it was void, then we just had to continue execution. And then once it threw the exception, it just threw up to the ether.
Somewhere.
Yeah.
And in this instance, it was...
It was Visual Studio.
It was Visual Studio and the app. The whole app crashed.
The whole app crashed.
Gotcha.
So that's that. That's async void and why you should await or not use it.
Yeah. So how do I fix it?
So to fix it, you could return... let's see. You could just return a task, or you could have a try catch within it.
Oh, okay.
So if you just add a try catch there, then because you're awaiting here, this is try catch. Oh, here, because we're throwing internally.
I see.
So okay. So we already have the try catch, but we're throwing it because if this is an internal library, maybe you want to bubble up that exception. So if you don't throw it and you handle it internally, it'll work, but you never know with internal libraries that might have async void.
Got it. So would you say a best practice here would actually not to be to handle it here, but probably add task?
Exactly. So instead of an async void, you could make it into a task with the task completion source, asyncify it, and then you can await it properly.
All right, so it's throwing an exception. Mm-hmm. So how do we fix it?
Yep, it's pretty simple. So instead of returning void, we just return a task.
Okay.
And because it's an async method, we don't actually have to return anything, and it'll just accept that.
Okay, cool. So let's check it out here. So it's a task, but...
So let's add the namespace. And then here, in the calling method, it'll give us squigglies because we're not awaiting. So let's await that properly so we can handle the exception. We just need to add async to this lambda in the command, and then await right here. And then this should run as we expect.
Now in that method, it was throwing an exception before, so is it still going to throw that exception?
Yes, it's still going to throw the exception. We didn't change the method. We just changed it to a task.
All right, let's check it out.
All right. Here we need...
Yeah, don't need to return anything.
Yep. All right.
So would another method be, let's say you can't change your signature to it. Let's say it has to be void because it's an event.
Yep.
Right? How would you handle that?
So in that case, I would maybe do a task.run with a continueth.
Okay.
And then handle the fault continuation option.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's one way to do it. I think that might be the best way, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got it. Cool. All right, let's take a look at it now.
All right.
We have async void.
Async void. Try catch. All right, so we'll see the task started, and we haven't completed, and then our exception is caught.
Boom.
Async void exception.
Easy peasy.
There we go.
So get rid of your async voids, unless you can't, and then kind of do that, or handle all the exceptions in there, right?
Exactly.
That'd be the other thing. Very cool. Easy. Peasy.
Yeah.
Async void, don't do it. Task. Tasks are your friend, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
Exactly.
Now, how often do you see this out in the wild, too? Because to me, it's like, all right, cool Dean, cool demo, but like, is this a thing that people are doing?
This is a very big thing, very big, because it's very easy to miss this kind of exception within a task, because in .NET, everything can be caught, try catch, that's the way we do it. But it's kind of sneaky when you have tasks that complete with an exception that don't really throw.
Gotcha. Very cool.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else for async void?
Use it properly now that you know how to.
Very cool. Well, Dean, thank you so much for this sort of quick best practice. You can find all of Dean's code, all of his best practices for async await, and the entire series of best practices for Xamarin at aka.ms/Xamarin best practices. Dean, thanks so much for this quick one.
Thanks so much, James.
Awesome. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. And don't forget to subscribe wherever you're watching right now for more Xamarin Awesome. I'm James Montemagno. This is The Xamarin Show. And thanks for watching. Hey, James here. Just wanted to check in and thank you for watching this video. Now do all the things that you know you want to do, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell. Become part of the notification squad. While you're here, check out all these awesome videos that I've already recorded. Click on that thing. Click it. Watch it. Do it.